Pues a la verga de estos Luis vamos. Hey.
But you know the best thing about this cruise position you have? You don't have to go back to work.
No.
You know today destroys the night. Night divides the day. Try to run.
Chop.
Like a line. Break on through to the other side. Break on through to the other side. In the
darling, stand by me. Whoa. Stand by me.
Now, see that bridge there? It's on the right. Santis is on the right now. See, there's Santis. Oh, there's a sign. Disculpa. Video camera. Sorry.
No good. Wow.
Yeah, they got run. There used to be a wooden statue of Havana. Here.
And it's the only region producing all varieties of tobacco for premium cigars. I mean, Cohiba, Monte Cristo, Romeo and Juliet, and so many brands. We have in Cuba, my friends, 250 different sizes and shapes, as you can see, and 27 different brands. For those who don't smoke, they most of the time believe that very thinner cigars are going to be much milder than fat cigar, which is completely the opposite. I mean, the fatter cigars, no way. They burn very slowly, and they deliver a large volume of rounder smoke that drains your palate with the full mixtures of flavors. Thinner cigars, they smoke quickly and they concentrate the flavors in the tip of your tongue, giving to you a bitter, sharper taste. Even though the cigar roller can omit the full flavor leaves in one thinner cigar, and this could be mild, okay? Because remember, to have a cigar, we need a combination and a recipe of different leaves coming from different positions in the plant, which I will explain later on. Some are going to provide the strength, some are going to provide the aroma, some are going to provide the combustibility, and so. And as you may know, every year, this year, February, we begin 26th up to the 2nd of March, we have the Cigar Festival, which we welcome in Cuba. We gather 1,000 people, 800, 900, 1,000, 100. And then visitors from all over the island, I mean from all over the world, people which are linked to tobacco business, people which are distributors, people which are passionate of Cuban cigars, celebrities are coming, distributors are coming, and then we organize, Cuban organizers, a Habano Sommelier contest, the longest ash contest, the magistral class to roll cigars, visiting to the plantation in one day, and the auction at the end of the festival. In the closure night, they also give a special prize to the person who has done the most in tobacco, in favor of tobacco. And this prize is given in three different categories: business and retails, communication and marketing, promotion, and then you have production category. In the production category, up to now, farmers, we have only six of them. From these six, three of them unfortunately passed away. Alejandro Robaina passed away, Antonio Maria Lins passed away, and Gerardo Medina passed away. So we get three left, and one of those three left, it is Hector. Hector has the distinction to be the youngest man who has done this prize in 2008. So he's considered to be the youngest man who has done it, and this is mainly done when you are elder, when you are about 60, 65, having the best result of the country in production of tobacco for at least 7, 8, or 10 years consequently, okay? So, we did it, I mean, actually did it in 2008. This is the award, the prize. This is the certificate given by Havanos Incorporated to Hector Luis Prieto in the face of producing tobacco. There are now, from that date on, there are different magazines like Cigar Journal, like Cigar Aficionado, where you can find an article from this plantation referring to Hector at that time when it was at the beginning, Cuba's rising star. Hector, you have met him before. Miguel is the cigar roller. The gentleman's gonna roll a cigar later on for you to see how we do it. And I mentioned, we have 13 acres and we're planting 200 to 150,000 plants. We have both the shade grown tobacco, like this one, where tobacco is completely covered with these long sheets of muslin cloth. This is filtering the sunlight. We have less sun, reducing it up to 30%, provoking the leaf to be much taller because they have more humidity. The leaves are gonna be thinner, oilier, pliable, and very elastic for the wrappers of the cigar, okay? Wrappers contributes very little to the cigar, but it stands as an ultimate symbol of the aesthetic, of the perfection. So the wrapper do not give, like some people says, 70% of the taste, no. The wrapper gives only 3% of the taste, but it represents, I mean, the quality of the cigar. Now, fillers are very important because fillers are coming from sun-grown tobacco. And in the sun-grown tobacco, we have four different classes of leaves. That's why, while we are growing tobacco, we have to remove the side shoots. We have to remove, like in tomatoes, the buds. We don't need flowers, my friends. Flowers we have after being recollected. And we don't need the flowers because we are not producing the seeds. We have a Tobacco Research Institute of Cuba that in this region, the farmers are provided both the seeds or the seedlings, okay? This is a denomination appellation area, so we are very well controlled with these matters. And then, while growing them, you do all what I tell you, and after 40, 50 days more or less, sometime you can see by accident, you can see that the tip of the leaves are becoming, or they have a very yellow, shadow that represents by instant you're having 90% of chlorophyll level. You can measure it right now, but long ago you didn't measure it, and the farmers, they used to be cultivating tobacco at that time. And then when it happens, after 40, 50 days, according to the maturing of the plant, we begin to harvest them. We do pick them from bottom to top, three leaves, four leaves every 5 days, or four leaves every 7 days. It depends on how the plant has been developed. We do it from bottom to top, but we do only three leaves every 5 days, more or less. The reason why we do this, it is because, as I told you, we have four different classes of leaves, which according to the position in the plant, they determine strength, flavor, combustibility, and aroma. Let's say, this one, medio tiempo, a very rare leaf to be produced in the upper part of the foliage. We say, plenty of people are asking, has medio tiempo ever existed? Or did it start to exist from 1996? And so, did it start to exist from 2010? Because the medio tiempo, you could barely find it in the plant. And it grows, from my point of view, I'm not an expert, it grows by nature. The farmers may intend to do it, and they don't do it. So occasionally, the medio tiempo grows in the upper part of the plant. It means they are very short in production. And this is the only one being used in Cohiba, Mexique, 52, 54 and 56, a size that was launched for the first time in 2010 officially, and brings extra flavor and aroma to the cigar. The expert says they have more energy receiving it as after you start recollecting. At the end of the recollection, you have three leaves missing. One of them, which is not paired with the other one, could be medio tiempo. The photosynthesis process in this one is more active. They are receiving more sun. So the nutrients, they convert it very fast, and they have more resin, more nicotine, more substances to be headed as medio tiempo. That's why they get late when you're going to dry them, they get late, or they get longer time to be dry, fermented, and also age. Imagine that the fermentation process for medio tiempo even lasts the third up to 120 days, which is not normal. For example, the full flavor, it goes up to 90 days, but this one goes up to 120 days of fermentation by heat and humidity, avoiding the ammonia, the chlorine, the acidity, the tar, and the nicotine on the leaves, okay? Then you have full flavor, which is for the strength. Medium flavor, very essential to the aroma of the cigar. And in the bottom, you have the light flavor, that which is helping the combustibility. That's what we're using for binders, and that which is all together forming the structure of a cigar. That's why when rolling a Cuban cigar, we need a combination, and we need a recipe being monitored and specified by the regulatory council of the brand in order to respect every cigar's individual characteristic. That's what we can find in Cohiba, 22 different Cohibas, from the Line 1492, which is medium to full flavor, to Mexique, which is full flavor, or to Robustos, or to Splendidos, or to Lanceros. I mean, we can find a wide variety of them. But if you go to Monte Cristo, you can find, I don't know, 30 Monte Cristos. You begin by the number one to the number five, and then you go later for the Torpedos, special ones, Monte Cristo A, then the new ones like Dantes, like Dumas, and so on, the age, and so on. That means we have a wide variety of tobacco for producing wide varieties of cigars. The tobacco is recollected from the fields and transported to the barns, to the curing barns. There we can see what women are doing. Okay? Good? Any question? Let's go for it.
Okay. El tabaco. Sí. No, y la semana que viene vengo con el amigo John de Escocia, que llega el lunes, pasado mañana llega.
Ah, yeah. Okay, these plants
I did myself recollect all the leaves because we have daily tourists coming here and they want to have pictures in the fields. I never allow them to go deeper because they break the leaves. So this is a show, this is a picture area, okay? So don't look too much at that. But here you can see from this on.
Ed.
Side shoots were Ed. Taken already, as you can see.
The
then we have a very even and flat plantation. This is a 62,000 plant field. As you can see, it's completely shaded in order to grow the wrappers, the outer leaves of the cigar. Leaves are being harvested, as you can see already, and later we will have what we call the regrown. The regrown in some regions, in some areas, in some farms, they reuse it for cigarette industry or whatever they sell it. We prefer to cut it, to let it on the field to replenish the soil. So then we will have more nutrients on the fields. The plants, what they get the most in the field, it is nitrogenous matters like phosphorus, potassium, magnesium. So why the plants are growing, our pH, as I told you, is very neutral, 6.97. I mean, Nicaraguan cigars, Dominican cigars are different from us, from some other reasons, but our pH is neutral. Some areas in the fields, perhaps in that corner, perhaps over there, you have too much acidity. And to regulate this acidity, we put potassium and magnesium working on together. They are going to balance the acidity of the soil. In Nicaragua, they have volcano, you know, like volcano soil.
Volcano soil.
And then this volcano soil, it's too rich. It has a lot of acidity, and sometimes the fermentation has to be longer, sometimes the aging process has to be longer, and that's why you can see the ashes of those Dominican and Nicaraguan cigars are burning very white because of too much magnesium and potassium in the fields. But anyway, it's not our business to talk about that. We recollect it from bottom to top. We don't use this, and we prefer to let it on the ground for replenishing the soil. After you have done, or while you're doing the recollection, then we transport it to the barns, or dry barns, where the women are patiently using a needle and a thread, and they are stitching the leaves together in a sequence operation. One left and one right, hanging in poles. In every pole, we may have 120 leaves if it is shade-grown tobacco, or 240 if it is sun-grown tobacco, okay? Let's go to have a look. If you want to walk in or take a picture, please be my guest.
A touching moment.
Touching, yes. The Buddha. Rubbing the Buddha.
Huh?
You ain't there. Oh, no, I'm fine.
Vamos.
Okay, we go.
Charlie, your friend is calling.
Pues, ¿te puedo dar?
Sí.
Están, pones el dedo así como una pistola. Así yo puedo hacer fotos con él.
Inside here using a needle and a thread, and they are stitching the leaves together in a sequence operation. So the leaves are going to be hanging, as you see here, one left and one right. Through the central vein, they are being tracked. The windows or the shutters, we open them for the fresh air circulation. If we need humidity, we can put water in the dirty soil. The leaves progressively, as you may see, they change its color from green to yellow, yellow to brown.
The time to be dry depends on the position of the leaves in the plant. Can be 45 to 60 days, more or less. Or sometimes it gets longer, though they say 45 to 50 is okay, 60 days. Then while drying them, the men, we need to climb on these ladders to the top, and we need to move the poles, rotate them, upper ones, bottom ones. We may have to make a rotation in order to get a drying process very homogeneously at the end of 60 days, more or less. Leaves are dry, but they are far away to become a cigar. They have toxic substances, like I mentioned, chlorine, the acidity, tar, nicotine, and so, and we need to avoid them through fermentation process. The fermentation process is very simple, but it's very important, very essential to the quality of the cigar, because it will clean, it will sweet out all the impurities in the leaves, the one I mentioned. And in order to do the fermentation, we have to wait until we have certain humidity inside the barn. If we don't have certain humidity in the environment, then we can put water in the dirty soil and they will absorb it. But that time, we cut the thread that stitched them and we make bundles with the same thread. We tie them. The bundles are going to be 45 to 60 leaves because it's half a pole. And these bundles, afterwards, over the poles, as you see there, we make a huge pile or mountain of tobacco, which is well organized. Tip of the leaf to the inner part, back part of the leaf to the outer part, and then we can make a mountain that can be 6 meters long, 2 meters wide, 150 high. We shade it with the same tissue. We have to cover the fields. By that time, when you shade them, you are provoking anaerobic fermentation process because you have no oxygen. Then heat and humidity, they combine to generate compression, and you need a constant supervision. Sometimes you need to have a sword thermometer that you will place in the package, inside there, to control what temperature you have in. From 19 Celsius to 35 will be good for the bottom and the medium. But from 19 to 40 Celsius will be good for the full flavor of medio tempo. So composting the leaves makes the ammonia to get into condensation while nicotine goes down. And this should be repeated 3 times. The farmer does only the first fermentation. Later you pack your tobacco and sell it to the government. The government, they receive it, they spray water with a fine spray, they lose the leaves in a huge tray, they moist it with a little bit of water, we never use additives, they turn it up after 15 minutes, and later it goes to a place which is called pre-fermentation process, where they make a huge mountain again of the same tobacco, lose, but then that's to get a certain percentage of humidity that later on the leaves are handled and the women can work with them. Because after that second fermentation, 15 to 25 days, it goes to a sorting and grading room where the ladies are going to patiently classify them by 3 criteria: size, color, and texture. But at the same time, they will strip out the central nerve, the central vein. If it is for the medio tiempo, for the full flavor, for the light flavor leaves, they do it 50% of it. If they do it for the bottom leaves, only 30%, because those are going to be the binders. And then it goes to a third fermentation that I mentioned to you. Could be 45 to 60 for the bottom ones, 60 to 80, 60 to 90 for the medium and full flavor, and even 120 days for the medio tempo. So after all that, they use an artificial barn where they dry it artificially. So they dry it up to 12% of humidity to be packed in bales of 45, 50 kilos. And these bales, they press it, they compress it. They have, or we can use Utah sack or the bark that loses the palm tree leaves. Then the packages, they have a card outside in which they write every detailed information of this tobacco. Then it goes to the warehouses from the government for storing them through the aging process. It goes for the aging process. The minimum time it should go for, it is 9 months, the bottom leaves. The leaves of the middle, a year and a half, could be aging. And the leaves of the top could be even 2 years of aging. This aging process benefits tobacco like a good whiskey, like a good cognac, like a good rum, because tannins are released while sugar level increases to produce a mellower, distinctly full, aromatic, voluptuous flavors in a cigar, but never aggressive. We need 500 up to now, 539, handmade operation, a minimum 2 years for a good cigar. From the seeds to the ashes. A farmer, Hector, Robina, Jesus, Carlos, anyone, can be in charge of 500,000 plants. And each of them should be visited at least 150 times during the growing season. Okay? So, a good cigar, I mean, we say, every country has, or everything in the world has a distinction, and there are things in the world which are very unique, and its own unique. We say, Cuban cigars are very unique, and Cuban cigars are Cuban cigars. You can find Dominican, Nicaraguan, whatever, but 90 million cigars that were produced the year before this one were not enough. Last year, 82 million cigars, not enough. You go to certain shops in Cuba, and you better find cigars out of Cuba than in Cuba. Of course, the price is going to be double ones. But you don't find Bajiques, you don't find Regionales, you don't find limited edition, you don't find this, because Cuban cigars are very well demanded. Okay? Any question or something you want to ask? Good to know. Vamos bien, caballero.
Sí, señor.
Vamos.
No, increíble. Lo único que dijimos José y yo es esperamos que esté.
Bandido, ¿verdad? Okay, let's go to see Miguel rolling a cigar.
Back.
And then we're good. Miguel is going to roll a cigar from the very beginning to the end. We use a vegetable glue, which is a resin of a tree imported from Canada. It has no taste, no flavor, it's tasteless, anomalous. Before this, we used to have corn flour. Now we're using this. And he's going to blend different leaves in order to see how we do it. If you want to do photos and pictures, please go ahead. I've been told you're coming from Austria.
Yeah, sure.
Vienna, Linz, Graz, Salzburg.
Near Vienna.
Near Vienna. Enjoy this. Later we'll talk.
No, esto es una vitolita chiquita.
¿Qué vas a ver?
46.
46.
Sí.
Flaquito.
No, 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 46, corona gorda.
No, corona gorda ya no es tan flaquito.
Por el 46, vamos a ver.
It's gonna roll a 46. Corona gorda.
Oh.
¿Dónde está Alejandro?
¿Eh?
Alejandro.
En su casa, viene a trabajar lunes y martes más o menos. Voy a La Habana el lunes y martes.
¿Para el festival?
Nah, voy a dar una vuelta a Ramón, el amigo mío, y eso.
¿Voy a hacer control de calidad o qué?
Champion, dime. Sergio, bueno. ¿Ya conociste a Nino?
No.
Hola. Nino Muñoz tiene un blog, es bloguero de tabaco.
¿Ah? ¿Dónde?
Muy bueno. Él es fumador de puros en Suiza.
Ah.
Él le gusta mucho los puros.
¿Conoce al señor Porma?
Sí, claro.
Él fue el que me trajo aquí hace 15 años.
So the filler has to be molded. We have to compress it here in the mold and the press for 15-20 minutes. After 15-20 minutes, we have to turn it up 15-20 more minutes. So once it gets compressed and compact and solid, we use the wrappers.
En la nevera está agua.
¿Tengo botita?
Well, in the factories, they use this cutting punch to do it very rounded, huh? Like he, but he did it just with like the...
Ripping a new asshole.
Era la chelo jefe mío.
No.
Eso, eso, eso lo hay.
Mira, al caballero, al único caballero del grupo, the only gentleman in the group.
Wow.
How's that? How's that, man?
How's that?
We resemble that remark.
You can't argue with that.
Wow.
Gracias.
Gracias, porque tú estás de la guía, vinieron ella. Vamos a pasar a ver, para ver cómo trabaja. Sí, otro vaina. Ok.
Oh.
Hola.
Ah, oh, okay.
Quick and just very delicate.
Yes. It's been rolling.